Welcome back to Living Golf's program on Innovators in the Game. Earlier, we met a number of established names in the industry. Now to focus on a few newcomers who want to grab their share of the global golf market.
Few sports lend themselves to the information age as golf. As players, we love stats, numbers, discussing handicaps, analyzing your swing, or searching for new golf courses. So it's no surprise that social media is crammed with internet sites and apps on the game.
It's an extremely competitive market, and many startup businesses have failed as trends rapidly change. We've come to Luxembourg to profile a company who's trying to buck that trend. AllSquare Golf is a specialized social media network for the golfing community. With over 60,000 users, including a few big names, and 33,000 courses on its platform, it's Facebook and TripAdvisor rolled into one.
AllSquare is a story that started a couple of years ago when I was playing in the Swiss national team and Patrick, my business partner, was playing in the Luxembourg golf team. And at that time, we realized that the golf market was extremely fragmented.
We came up with this idea of unifying the golf market during our studies in Switzerland. Today, we're here in Luxembourg with 10 people, growing our business, wanting to expand it to the United States in 2016. We allow golfers to actually connect with each other, share their passion for the game, and also discover new courses and new destinations. If we want to go to, let's say, PJ Catalunya Resort, the stadium course, they can see the weather forecast, read the description about the golf course, and then also find reviews from like-minded golfers. There's really been a big shift in the golf industry towards technologies. People are realizing that the golf industry needs to change and needs to grasp new technologies to actually get the game more exciting. We also have a What's in My Bag section. We're working on a feature where people could actually purchase equipment directly from their friend's profile.
While open to all demographics, it's clear such an idea is suited to the younger generation of golfers. A peer group that isn't so tied down to one career, location, or lifestyle.
Today, it's very difficult to say that someone is going to have a career in London for his whole life. So why should he pay a membership in one club in London and not be able to play in New York when he travels? And so a global membership would make a lot of sense. And this is something that we are actually thinking about. So it's really about building the community, bringing the stakeholders together, and eventually one day offering such a global membership for people to play and enjoy golf.
Away from the traditional corridors of power, could this be the next big development in the global game? Let's face it, the 21st century has seen massive development in the area of social media. So could the timing be just right for startup businesses like this to really unify the golf market?
We need to stay innovative. Obviously, we're a European-based startup, and we're setting a foot in Silicon Valley, which will keep us up to date with, well, technologies and innovation. So in the end, we need to make sure that we keep on innovating and keep on, well, delivering a high-value service.
Most importantly, it's about really having an impact in the golf industry, bringing some change along, and positioning my company as a leader in the golf industry and a place to go to, a marketplace for golf.
From online to on screen. Golf's varied topography has meant graphics on television have been slow to catch up compared to other sports with flatter, computer-friendlier fields of play. Dr. Paul Hawkins and his company, Hawkeye Innovations, hope to change all that.
Innovation isn't something that's that easy. It's not just as easy as just switching on the innovation button. So clearly lots of things have been tried and continue to be tried, and some work and some don't.
It was cricket that first got the ball rolling for Hawkins. A keen player, he saw a lack of analysis of the sport on TV in the 90s. He invented a system called Hawkeye, in which cameras placed around the field of play are triangulated to create a 3D illustration of a ball's trajectory. Hawkeye's functionality not only transformed how cricket was broadcast, but its accuracy led to the governing bodies deploying it to help officiate on the game.
Pretty much our mission now is the same as it was then, just now in a much wider variety of sports. We do 24 different sports all around the world, and just look at each different sport and work out from an application-led perspective how we can help each sport and then apply the right technology for the right sport.
Using pioneering techniques from cricket as well as over 20 other sports they work in, Hawkeye's plans for golf is to focus primarily on the likely path of a putt before a player attempts the shot. With contours, type of grass, and the natural elements all to consider, it's not an easy calculation. For most, anyway.
Our ability to map the greens is a fairly standard piece of technology, actually. We need to do the same for a tennis court. And so it's really just applying that technology to a golf green. It's a pretty standard process of taking an area of ground and working out the contour map of it. So we can now make a prediction of exactly the line they need to putt on, but not just a line, more of an envelope, because the line is dependent on the pace of the putt. And so some putts you can actually set off in a very different angle with different paces and still end up in the hole. So we can show the difference between a downhill putt and an uphill putt, for example, in terms of your variation. You know, is it a speed putt or is it a line putt? And I think there are ways which we can enhance the fan experience, make them appreciate what's going on, and I think probably most importantly, just enhance the entertainment side of it and actually make it fun, put smiles on people's faces.
Can Hawkeye help change the face of golf on TV? Judging by their track record in other sports, watch this space. Steve Jobs once said, innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower. With trailblazers continually changing the game, golf may not be as traditional as some may think. Until next month on Living Golf, bye-bye.